some interesting personality with us. She is a beautiful lady and a very intellectual and a powerful woman as well. So I welcome on board Dr. Reena Arora. She's from Delhi. And there is so much to talk about Dr. Reena here. She has a wonderful profile. She's been practicing Ayurveda since 20 years now. She's done her Panchakarma diploma. She's also a certified yoga practitioner. And she's won various awards for her articles that she's been presenting internationally. She's won the best award for in the Ministry of Ayush for the prevention of diabetes through Ayurveda in the modern times that we see now. She's also presented her papers for PCOD disorders. She's also done a lot of work for people who are suffering from obesity and urinary disorder. Okay. No, there are so many other things that she has contributed there. She is also a regular speaker for All India Radio and Doordarshan, which has been played in India. So that's the, she gives a lot of health talks on that particular radio shows as well. She also participates around the globe in so many talk shows, and you know, she just wants to share her knowledge and whatever she's done, her contribution in the field of Ayurveda. Dr. Reena Arora is also a brand ambassador of Baidyanath. She looks pretty beautiful in that advertisement, I must say. And she is a brand ambassador since 2007. And she's also a consultant at Patanjali. That's again a very huge brand for Ayurveda that we say. And I must tell you all that she doesn't charge fees because for that particular section, because she runs and visits so many charitable trusts across India. And also, she is a fantastic, she has a fantastic list of Ayurvedic recipes that she shares with her patients and clients. And she always has an alternative for the junk food that we eat, which is not really nice. So, you know, I am just wondering, Dr. Reena, that there is so much to talk about you. And we are so happy and lucky to have you on our panel tonight. Welcome, Dr. Reena. And as also I know that you also had a talk show with Rashmi today, who is Mrs. Scotland Universe, and she's also founder of Good People TV. So we have an international celebrity here with us. So Dr. Reena, over to you.
Namaskar, and thank you, Purva, for giving such a nice introduction. And I am thankful to IIW for inviting me and Rashmi ji. Today, the topic of my talk is Ayush Samvad, Ayurveda for COVID-19. And this is an initiative of Ministry of Ayush and All India Institute of Ayurveda for spreading awareness about COVID-19 and Ayurveda, because the cases are again increasing now. So we should again follow the Ayush advisory, dietary advices, and all other things they have advised, which I am going to describe today. Yes, please, next slide, Purva. Yes, this is Ayush Samvad. I have explained about this, Ayurveda for COVID-19. My health, my responsibility. This should be the motive of every person, because this is not a, as a proverb is there, that Rome was not built in a day. Same is the case with immunity. This cannot be done with popping a tablet and your immunity will increase. This is a routine procedure. You should follow these things to make your immunity strong so that any virus cannot attack you, any virus or bacteria or any disease, and you are very happy and healthy. Next slide, Purva. Yes, this is next. This is about All India Institute of, yes, this is. Now, what is Ayurveda? Ayurveda is derived from Ayu, meaning long life, and Veda meaning knowledge. Every person is interested in long life and happy life, and people search on Google or other social sites, how to increase my life, how to boost my immunity, how to do all these things. Answer is only one thing, Ayurveda. By this, which I am going to explain, you can increase your immunity and your life can be happier. Ayurveda is a knowledge system of healthy and happy life. This is helpful in illness, in maintaining your wellness, and in happiness. I am citing an example here. If you visit a lab for routine testing and your all the parameters are normal, but you are about to cry, you are not healthy in the definition of Ayurveda. A person is healthy only if your lab parameters are okay, your digestion is okay, your stomach clears in the morning, you are happy internally. You are not just giving social smile. This is the definition of a healthy person according to Ayurveda. Next slide, Purva. Yes, previous one. Previous slide, Purva. Next. We are leaving one slide in between. Previous slide, Purva. Next. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Ayurveda is rooted in community. So this is helpful for public health. The Ayurveda has potential to meet health and wellness for all, which is the goal of WHO also after this pandemic. Because even our mothers told us in our childhood, whenever a child injures, she says that you take turmeric milk, you apply this. So these things are rooted in our community. These are not new. But I will like to say one thing here. As these things are advised in this Ayush advisory and for COVID-19 pandemic, there is a huge scientific data behind these advisories. This is not said in vain without any background that you take turmeric or you take this. Next slide, Purva. Yes. Aim of Ayurveda is Swasthasya Swasthya Rakshanam Aturasya Vikar Prashmanamacha. Means you should not visit a doctor when you are ill. You should also visit an Ayurvedic doctor for maintenance of your health. This is the aim of Ayurveda, to protect the health of a healthy person and to cure the sick person. And it means this is for prevention of diseases, for promotion of health, and for maintenance of health. This Ayurveda works and for management of diseases. These are three pillars of Ayurveda: diet, sleep, and celibacy. And in Ayurveda, there is personalized holistic approach. See, for example, on social sites, we get such type of messages that take a lot of water, take hot water in the morning, take aloe vera juice, take this. You should not do this blindly without visiting a doctor, because there are seven type of prakriti, that this is constituency of a person advised in Ayurveda. For example, Vata, Pitta, and Kapha. Vata, Pitta, Pitta, Kapha, and all these things. And if a thing which you are taking according to a social site advice, for example, hot water, and this is not suiting you, then you will think what happened. A Pitta person should not take hot water in the morning. This is the difference. So Ayurveda is a personalized holistic approach. Every person is unique. His or her identity is unique, and his or her dietary and lifestyle advices will be different. So don't follow blindly social sites or YouTube or any other thing. You should first see your whole body. You should visit a doctor and then you should take. Next slide, Purva. Strengths of Ayurveda. This is time tested. 5,000 years old Ayurveda is working even in this era. So this is time tested, cost effective. Quality and safety efficacy is assured after this Ayush ministry is formed. And before that also, there is GMP certified drugs are brought in the market. Immunomodulators are available in this system. Rejuvenation, this is the best part. Even after post-COVID symptoms, people are feeling weakness, tiredness. This rejuvenation part is helping a lot in this. Then palliation therapy, this old age people or tertiary care treatment also, this works. Then this has holistic integrated approach. And then various choices of treatment are available. There are decoctions available, churnas available, tablets available. Then yoga is also there, panchakarma. These are biopurification procedures, which everyone should do. If you are ill, only then you should not undergo panchakarma. Even if you are not suffering from any disease, you can go for this detoxification procedure every year. You will not suffer from diseases if you are undergoing these procedures. Then mental and spiritual healing, which is need of the time. Everybody is stressed. Whatever, how much money and everything you are getting, even then you are not happy, then what you require, you need mental peace. So this helps a lot in this field of people. Then this is time tested. This is the prevention and treatment and restoration. This is the beauty of Ayurveda. Next. Then again, strengths of Ayurveda. Comprehensive definition of health means this is helpful in every aspect for maintaining health. Then acceptance by the community. Whole world is accepting Ayurveda. There is shortage of drugs of Ayurvedic medicines in this time. Then emphasis on promotion of health and prevention of diseases. Importance of diet and lifestyle. Every person when visit my clinic, I take 1 hour in assessing the whole prakriti of that person in telling him or her their diet and lifestyle. This diet or lifestyle should be according to your age, according to your disease, according to your profession, according to season, and many more things are counted in this. Then this is a holistic concept of health. Then individualized approach, universal, individualized, I have explained earlier that every individual is unique. So you should not follow blindly any other person's advice. Universal approach, then stress on public health and eugenic. Public health, you all know, but eugenic, I would like to explain here because we try to mutate the genes also. We advise antenatal care. By this, good genes can be activated and good progeny can be brought in this world. Then use of natural products, multiple areas of clinical strength, unique therapeutic approach. These are preventive, promotive, predictive. Preventive, I have explained. Then promotive, that means promotion of health. Predictive, we can predict that whether a disease is about to come by a symptoms of the disease. And participatory, patients are expert participants. They are aware of all these things. Then curative, Ayurveda is helpful in curing diseases. Next slide, Purva. Yes, Ayurveda knowledge system of healthy and happy life. There are 8 branches of Ayurveda. This is internal medicine, pediatric, psychiatry, eye and ENT, surgery, toxicology, geriatrics, and rejuvenation. So these work on cause of the disease, how they affect, and the management. The holistic management includes biopurification, oral medication, diet, lifestyle, yoga, and meditation. Next slide, Purva. Yeah. Now, how epidemics is explained in Ayurveda? There is a Janpada Dhvans Rog explained in Charak Sanhita. This is our textbook. And in this, 4 parameters are affected. This is Vayu, that is airborne diseases. Jal, that is whole water is polluted. Then Desh, that means environment and call. And by in the one other definition is there, Upsargik Rog means infectious diseases. This is explained in Sushruta Sanhita. This is also one another textbook of Ayurveda. Prasangat gatra sanspashnat nishvaspar sah bhojanat sah shayyasana chapi vastram malya anulopinat means when you share all the things, you share clothes, you eat together and you sit together, you sleep together, then the infectious diseases are transported from one person to another. Same are the guidelines for COVID, that you avoid these things for prevention of COVID-19. Next slide, Purva. Yes, anukta vyadhis in Ayurveda. See, there are many diseases which are not named, but they are defined in Ayurveda indirectly. So this is a reference of my textbook, Vikar Naam Akushalo Na Jivyat Kadachana Nahi Sarv Vikar Naam Namato Asti Dhruvasthita. Every disease should not be named. There are many viruses like dengue, chikungunya, Zika virus, Cyrus, SARS-CoV, etc. These are newly discovered viral diseases. Many more diseases will come. How many vaccines and how many other things will be made for this? Ayurveda has explained these diseases according to Vata, Pitta, and Kapha. And Ayush Ministry has a lot of scientific data for these things, that these drugs and these advisories and dietary advisories are working on these viruses. So this is the reason that I have given this reference, that we can treat, and many patients are treated by only Ayurvedic medicines in All India Institute of Ayurveda, in TBR College, in Kheda Brahmaprakash. These are center for COVID patients. So we can tell now that many patients are cured by only Ayurvedic medicines. Even I have cured many COVID patients in this pandemic. And even now patients are taking online consultation from me. And you can take the benefits of these things by taking the Ayurvedic medicines. There is a famous doctor, Raghunandan Sharma in UK. You can take the consultation from him for these things. Next slide. Yes. Fourfold healthcare management is explained in Ayurveda. There is a physician which is required for treating. Medicine is required, then patient, and then nursing staff. If these four things are proper, then healthcare is at the best. My health is my responsibility, as I have explained earlier, that everybody should think about this. You have to maintain your health. You have to follow all the dietary regime, the seasonal regime, and other things which I'm explaining here. Next. Yes, coronaviruses are a large family of viruses that cause illness ranging from the common cold to severe disease. WHO has announced that COVID-19 is a pandemic. So I'm explaining little things about these because cases are again increasing. The incubation period is 2 to 14 days. Onset of symptoms average from 5 to 7 days. And acute onset of low to moderate grade continuous fever. Then symptoms, cough, dyspnea, fever, myalgia, headache, sore throat, loss of smell or taste, diarrhea, abdominal pain, and rhinorrhea. And then signs are tachycardia, decreased oxygen saturation, multi-organ involvement. Next slide. COVID-19 management principles. First, we prevent the virus entering to our cells. These are Ayurvedic prophylactic measures, which I will explain in further slides. Then stopping its replication if it gets inside the cells, reducing the damage that occurs to our tissues. This first in between, this is symptomatic Ayurvedic management, then restoration through rasayana. Next slide, please. Yes, prophylactic measures. Take chyawanprash 10 gram in the morning. Diabetics should take sugar-free chyawanprash. Then drink herbal tea or decoction made from tulsi, dalchini, kali mirch, shunthi, that is dry ginger, munakka, these are raisins, once or twice a day. You can add jaggery or natural sugar, and fresh lemon juice can be added if you want this, if you taste. And golden milk, that is half teaspoon haldi or turmeric powder, and 150 ml of hot milk once or twice a day. Then general measures advice, drink warm water throughout the day. Yes, next slide, Purva. These are simple yogic exercises which I have explained. Sukshma vyayam, that is loosening exercises for all joints, sitting postures, then yogasans in supine position, some yogas in prone position, then relaxing postures like shavasan, makarasan, pranayam, deep breathing, and meditation for 10 minutes for keeping your brain calm in this stressful world. Next slide, Purva. Yes. These are Ayurvedic immunity boosting measures for self-care in COVID-19. Nasya. If you will listen the benefits of Nasya, this is not only for COVID. This is also for maintaining the glow of your face, for falling of hairs, for your eyes, for your memory, and for your sharp brain. And in COVID pandemic, Nasya is, we put 2 drops of oil in your both nostrils by lying down like this, remove the pillow and lay down on bed. And you can put this oil in your both nostrils in the morning and at night. And then you lie down for 5 minutes. This is very good for in COVID prevention because this creates a biomass in nasal membrane, which is helpful in preventing any bacteria or virus entering there. Then Ayush Kwath, I have explained earlier, gargling. This is also called swish. You can put 1 teaspoon of sesame oil in your mouth and you gargle like this. And then after 5 or 10 minutes, you spit this. This is very good for dry mouth, for good teeth, and for teachers or persons who have a job of speaking more. Their vocal cords are damaged. So this helps in preventing this. And this is also very good for mouth health and for preventing any virus or bacteria from entering inside, because these two are main roots of COVID-19 virus entering. Then steam inhalation. This also prevents a lot of virus infections and open our channels. Then golden milk, I have explained. Next, Purva.
So doctor, the oil that you said, that can be any oil, or is it specific kind of oil that we need to?
Yes, I am telling 3-4 oils. You can use almond oil, You can use anu tel, coconut oil, or cow's desi ghee. Any of them. Yes. And then next, this you should drink warm water in this pandemic, because hot liquid is considered to be superior to cold liquids in the management of upper respiratory tract infections. There are a lot of studies on this, on the basis of which I am saying this. Next slide. Yes, spices like haldi, that is turmeric, cumin, coriander, and garlic are recommended in cooking. Kitchen is the primary pharmacy, because spices are the best medicine and they are best antioxidants. People are finding antioxidants on Google. So these are the best antioxidants, and in prevention of COVID-19 also, this thing also I am saying on the basis of huge scientific data. I am not saying by just seeing my kitchen that you use this. There is a scientific background behind these slides. Next slide, Purva. Yes. Immunoprotective role of Chyawanprash at cellular level mediated by immunity is proven in many research papers. So I have advised that you can take Chyawanprash in the morning, and diabetics should take sugar-free Chyawanprash. Yes, next. Then this Ayush Kwath, you can make this at home also if it's not available there. Take 3 or 4 leaves of tulsi, that is Osimum bacillus, and then raisins, a pinch of dalchini, that is cinnamon, then black pepper, 2 or 3 or 4 you can add, a pinch of this dry ginger. Boil this decoction for 5 minutes. Take 1 cup of this and 5 minutes on the sim, and cover this for 5 minutes. Then you can take this by straining or as it is, and you can add lemon juice or jaggery according to your taste. Next slide. This I have explained. Yes, one thing is here. For individuals having acidity or acid peptic diseases, advice of Ayurvedic doctor should be taken before taking this Ayush Kwath or decoction. And the rest, add 3 gram or 1 teaspoon Ayush Kwath powder. If it's not available, you make as I have explained you in 150 ml of water, and then allow it to boil and then switch off the flame. Keep it for 2-3 minutes and then strain the decoction and take it. Next slide. Yes, golden milk. In 150 ml of milk, you add 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder. This is golden milk, and this is very good. One precaution I would like to advise here, unmarried girls should stop in between this turmeric milk. They should not take continuously. Next slide. Yes, nasya. This is nasal application of 2 drops of CCM, as I have explained, coconut oil or ghee in both the nostrils. Even in, after COVID pandemic, you continue this, you will see the improvement in your eyes, on your face, on your hairs, memory, and many other things. Then you can use this in the morning or at night or at both times, as I have told. Next slide, Purva. Steam, yes. In COVID pandemic, if you are feeling the symptoms, you have breathing difficulties, you have cough, then you should take the steam only of fresh pudina or mint leaves or ajwain. This is caraway seeds. This can be used along with water once in a day. And it should be done, especially done during sore throat or dry cough. You should take this steam. Even after COVID pandemic, if you're suffering from these symptoms, you can take this. Yes, next Purva. Yes, this Sanshamani Vati is for fever. This is basically giloy. So you can take this Tinospora cardifolia. It's in whatever form it's available there. You can take 2 tablets twice a day. Or if you have this giloy ghan vati of any company, or Vaidyanath, Patanjali, or Dabur, whatever is available there, you can take twice a day or 2 tablets, 1 tablet thrice a day. And if it's better if you take the advice of an Ayurvedic doctor. Next slide. Yes.
Yes.
Now, this is very important part. Wholesome food, including all 6 tastes, should be taken. You should not see that this much calorie content I have to see, this. Ayurveda explains that all the 6 tastes should be present in your diet. This is the reason that some tastes are missing from our diet. Many diseases are arising. You are not taking any bitter thing in the diet. Children don't take any bitter thing like karela or this drumsticks or these things. So diabetics are increasing in India and in other countries also, and many other diseases are increasing. There are six tastes. It is sweet, sour, salty, bitter, astringent, and one more, pungent. So these six tastes should be there. And even the order of taking these tastes is advised in Ayurveda that we should take sweet first. So when we should eat only before the sun is sun sets. This is from before 6 p.m. we should finish all the meals. After that, we should not take the meals. Our lunch should be before 2 p.m. so that it's digested properly and the pitta is predominant during that period. Then how much we should eat? We should take our diet according to our hunger. Any dietitian cannot suggest your diet chart because she is not aware about your hunger. She is not aware that how much you are hungry at that time. She will say that you take 4 bread piece, 1 katori of dal, 1 katori of sabji. You will take all the things, whether you are hungry or not. This should not be the criteria. You should see yourself and decide that how much diet you should take. If you have done a lot of work on a particular day and you are feeling hungry and you are taking very rich, very low diet, and on the other day you are sitting in the AC office not doing anything and you are taking rich diet according to that dietitian, then this would be wrong. So how much should be decided only by you? But there is a simple procedure advised in Ayurveda that the cereal, solid food should fill the 50% of your stomach capacity. 25% should be filled by liquid foods and the rest should be kept empty for digestion, for movement of air. We should not eat up to this much extent that we are unable to get up from the chair. Otherwise, we do this thing in the functions. So this should be avoided. Next slide, Purva. Yes, these are diet guidelines in COVID management. Chew a piece of ginger with a pinch of rock salt 15 to 20 minutes before food to improve appetite. You should not consider these things only in reference of COVID management. Even if your appetite is not good, you can take this in routine. And the next is light to digest food preparations like soups of moong dal or lentil, soups of vegetables, meat soup if you are a non-veg person, khichdi of rice and moong dal, fulka with cow ghee, that is chapati, then vegetables like ghiya, turai, bhindi, sita, pumpkin, etc. you can take, or lady finger. Then use spices like cumin, black pepper, garlic, coriander, ginger, and ajwain. If appetite and digestion improve, start with normal diet and quantity of food as per your appetite. This is very important thing. Next. Yes, this is the lifestyle modifications in COVID management. Wake up early in the morning around 5 to 5:30 a.m. Ushnapan, that is drink warm water, 100 ml to 640 ml water stored in copper vessel. Then defecation and urination. After then, clean your face and oral cavity, that is brushing teeth with astringent toothpaste powder or tongue cleaning. Then frequent gargling with warm water added with salt and haldi. Whenever you go out for some work, you apply this oil in your both nostrils. And whenever you come back at home, then you do the gargles with this water and salt and turmeric. Then further washing face with warm water, then 2 drops of anu tail in each nostril. I have explained this, nasya. Then oil application daily at least on head, ear and foot if possible. If not, then preferably whole body once a week. Then light physical exercises. Next slide, Purva. Yes, the longevity, a way of life, my health, my responsibility. How we can achieve this? By taking a good diet, which is very nutritious, by maintaining the routine of exercise, massage, yoga, meditation, maintaining work-life balance, by happy state of mind, adequate rest, that is sleep, seasonal panchkarma. What is this seasonal panchkarma? We do explain that, for example, now the spring season is going on in India. If a person is suffering from asthma or such type of diseases, then he or she should undergo the natural vomiting procedures done in Panchkarma. Then if you are suffering from some skin diseases, you should undergo the natural purgation in Sharad Ritu, that is September and October. So these are some Panchkarma purificative procedures advised for a healthy person also. Then rejuvenating herbs we can take for rejuvenation. Next slide, Purva. Yes, these are frequently asked questions. Are there any traditional medicines or therapy that can prevent or cure COVID-19? Yes. Who has prepared the National Clinical Management Protocol? Ayush Ministry and many other reputed government organizations have prepared this. Is there any scientific rationale behind selection of drugs figuring in the protocol? Yes, there is a huge scientific data behind this. Then what is immunity in Ayurveda? Then are the recommended medicines safe? Yes. Is taking Ayush Kwath regularly injurious to liver? No. Are the medicines prescribed in the protocol immune boosting? Yes. Next slide, Purva. Yes. This is again the post-COVID management protocol. Ayush Kwath, which I've explained, should be taken. Then you can take Mulethi powder, 1 to 3 grams with lukewarm water. You can take warm milk with haldi, gargling with turmeric and salt. Then Chyawanprash. It is also suggested by Ministry of Ayush that Chyawanprash should be taken in the morning with lukewarm water. And these things should be done under the supervision of an Ayurvedic doctor. Next slide, Purva. This is the management of COVID patient. You can gargle this with thrice a day. You can take this guduchi and pipli chool twice a day, and Ayush Kada, then Sanshamni Vati, Sudarshan Ghanvati, Anutel Pratimashnasya, I explained earlier, steam inhalation with tulsi, pudina or ajwain, then Bilwadi Gutika, but these should be taken under the supervision of an Ayurvedic doctor. Next slide. Then post-COVID complications occur in heart, damage to heart muscle, lungs, brain and nervous system, mental health and musculoskeletal system. These can be cured by Ayurveda. Next slide. Then post-COVID management, this means we can take in this Ayush Kwath, Sanshamni Vati, Ashwagandha powder for weakness, Amla powder for increasing the immunity, Mulethi powder, Chyawanprash. Next slide. Again, what is the importance of rasayan in strengthening the host defense? This rasayan is for rejuvenating and increasing the immunity. Are the recommended medicines safe? Yes. Is there any research work? Yes. Has the ministry ensured the quality of the research work? Yes. What is the basis of recommending guduchi? There is a lot of scientific data behind explaining only guduchi in this COVID pandemic. And what is the basis of recommending ashwagandha in the protocol? There is also huge scientific data behind ashwagandha, which is very good rejuvenator. This is the reason this is explained in this. Then has any large-scale study been undertaken in Ayush for prophylactic care? Yes. 80,000 police personnel were studied for this these things. And in Medanta also, there is a study going on. Many other projects on this these protocols are going on right now. And Ayush Ministry has submitted the data for these things also. Next slide, Purva. Yes, these are the rasayan. Way to enhance your immunity. Guduchi can be taken, ashwagandha, haridra, amla, this is shatavari, and these are raisins. Next. Next slide. Yes. Thank you. And if any question is there, Purva, you can take.
What a wonderful presentation, Dr. Reena. And there is so much to understand and know about the perspective of Ayurveda. I think it is, if in our daily routine, if we kind of include this, I think it has cure for everything, right? Because it depends on the lifestyle that you just aapne bola. Ayurveda is not just for one person as a defined medicine. It depends on what lifestyle, what are your eating habits, and what are your regular habits that you take care of. So wonderfully explained, doctor, and thank you so much. So if everyone can unmute themselves, and if anyone has questions, please come forward. Everyone is asking for your recordings, and everybody is loving the session. I'm getting messages from everywhere. Thank you so much.
I will to share. Yes, Purva, I would like to share one thing here.
Yeah.
This Ayush advisory video, which you have run earlier, This is available on my YouTube channel, Dr. Reena Arora. There is one more video in which I have explained about diets in COVID pandemic and in post-COVID patients. So you can see there. There are many other my TV programs or radio programs available. You can see for other health updates. And if possible, please subscribe my channel so that you can know
That's
about
that. That's what I was going to tell, that we have just posted in the chat right now. We've posted your link where everyone can go. This is the COVID precautionary link that is given by Dr. Reena. And everyone can go and follow her channel as well, and also on her Instagram, because there is so much knowledge that she has to share. And I don't think in one session we could really take that. So I request everyone to go and watch that video. And just wanted to ask you, doctor, that, you know, this COVID pandemic just have aaya hai, and then, you know, it's still increasing, not just in India, but also around the globe. So what do you think are the basic things that a person should really follow, and how can Ayurveda be more effective for that? Because, you know, we as general people, we run to doctors and we have that allopathic medicines because we want quick results. We do not think about the longevity of our pain that is not going to get cured. So what do you, what are your thinkings about this?
First, I will like to tell one thing here, that your routine should be very good. Even if you're working from home, this should not be the scene that you are getting up at 9 and then you are doing your brush and switching on the laptop. And then whenever you get your time, you are taking bath at 2 or 3 or 8. This should not be the routine. You are going to office or no. Your routine should be same. You should get up early in the morning at 5 or 6. You go to toilet, then do some yoga. Then apply this oil in your both nostrils. Then do this swish. And then you make your proper breakfast. Then you take bath, then you take your breakfast, then you switch on your laptop if you're working from your home. And even when, if you're going out from your home, you apply oil in your both nostrils. This will act as a biomask. And after coming from your office or from any other place, you should gargle with haldi and this saline water. This should be a little bit hot. And you can gargle with this 3-4 times. Because the cases are increasing, for prevention, you can do this. And the Ayush path, I've explained, you can make this at home. You take Chyawanprash in routine till this pandemic ends. And take fresh meal, don't take stale meals. And you should prevent the processed foods and packed foods. We don't advise this. And stale foods have no nutritional value, according to Ayurveda. I don't take a meal which is left over, even whether it's any meal. This can be pizza. People are fond of this. I don't take again. We take only fresh meals and take fruits in proper quantity before lunch. You should not skip these things from your routine. So this is the reason I am saying that immunity is not a pill that you pop up this pill and your immunity is increasing. This increases day by day, that what is your lifestyle, how much good diet you are taking, and how is your sleep. So these things affect your immunity, your health. Hindi mein ek kahawat hai ki agar aapka kila strong hoga to aapko koi shatru attack nahi kar sakta. To basically haan, maine wahi baat boli hai ki aap apne kile ko strong rakhiye. Ye to ek covid virus aaya hai to itna sab log jagruk ho gaye hain health ke prati, aur wo virus bar bar apne strain change kar raha hai, to kis kis virus ke liye kya kya vaccine lagegi aur kitne
kya vaccine
aapko, to best wahi hai. और वैसे भी एक एग्जांपल और मैं देना चाहूंगी यहाँ पर, जैसे कितनी बीमारियां हैं, पहले भी टीबी है, कैंसर है, और भी कितनी इन्फेक्शियस डिजीजेस है, क्या सबको वो बीमारियां हो जाती हैं? नहीं, वो उसी को होती हैं जिसकी इम्यूनिटी वीक है. सड़क पे सारे चल रहे हैं और वो डस्ट पार्टिकल से भी टीबी होती है लोगों को, लेकिन वो सबको तो नहीं हो रही. हम भी चल रहे हैं, बाकी लोग भी चल रहे हैं. जो वीक है उसी को वायरस या बैक्टीरिया ने अटैक करना है. तो बेसिकली अभी भी वही है कि आपको अपनी इम्यूनिटी स्ट्रांग करनी है, आप तभी ठीक रह सकते हैं. वैक्सीनेशन करवाइए, वो बहुत अच्छी बात है. ये सब कुछ फॉलो कीजिए, क्योंकि लोग बहुत ज्यादा लीनियंट हो गए हैं, इसलिए भी केसेस इंक्रीज हो रहे हैं. मास्क नहीं पहन रहे कुछ लोग. और
डॉक्टर, ये वैक्सीनेशन, इफ आई कैन इंटरप्रेट, वैक्सीनेशन आपको क्या लगता है, मतलब बहुत ऐसा डबल माइंड सिचुएशन में लोग हैं कि वैक्सीनेशन इज नॉट रियली फ्रूटफुल, नहीं हम लोग को समझ में आ रहा, फिर से हो ही जाता है कोरोना, तो उससे अच्छा हम नहीं लेंगे क्योंकि वैक्सीन करने से हमको और बुखार आ रहा है, या फिर पता नहीं कुछ गलत तरीके से भी लोग वैक्सीन दे रहे हैं, बिकॉज आई थिंक देयर इज सम टेम्परेचर थिंग दैट यू हैव टू मेंटेन व्हाइल गिविंग द वैक्सीन, तो डॉक्टर्स भी नहीं कर पा रहे. सो हाउ आपको क्या लगता है कि इज इट राइट टू टेक वैक्सीन एट द राइट टाइम, विल इट बी हेल्पफुल फॉर अस?
यस, वी शुड टेक वैक्सीन. उसका रीजन ये है, देखिए अगर आप किसी भी तरह बच रहे हैं अभी तक उससे, कोविड से, और बाय चांस आपने वैक्सीन ली है, तो आप 100% फिर उससे इम्यून हो जाते हैं, क्योंकि आपके अंदर उसने जाके इम्यूनिटी डेवलप कर दी. बहुत कम चांसेस हो जाते हैं फिर आपको कोविड होने के. और दूसरा, अगर आप अपने लिए वैक्सीन नहीं लेना चाहते बट आपको लेनी चाहिए दूसरों को प्रिवेंट करने के लिए जो वीक है, ताकि आपको भी, आप उसके अगर कैरियर भी हैं कोविड के, आपको वो अफेक्ट नहीं कर रहा, लेकिन आप जिस सोसाइटी में जा रहे हैं आप दूसरे 100 लोगों को बीमार कर रहे हैं, तो दिस इज नॉट राइट. इसलिए यू शुड टेक वैक्सीन.
डॉक्टर, somebody is asking कि हम चवनप्राश can be taken by everyone, ये हम कोई भी ले सकता है, या फिर उसमें भी आपका बात पित्त वो सब देखना पड़ता है?
चवनप्राश सभी ले सकते हैं, बस इतना है कि डायबिटिक्स जो हैं वो शुगर फ्री चवनप्राश ले, अदरवाइज चवनप्राश कैन बी टेकन.
डॉक्टर, वी हैव वन मोर क्वेश्चन कि कैन अ पर्सन हु हैज मल्टीपल स्क्लेरोसिस टेक वैक्सीन?
ये मल्टीपल स्क्लेरोसिस का जो पेशेंट है, इनको अपने एक फिजिशियन को एक बार वैक्सीन लगवाने से पहले मिलना चाहिए, प्रॉपर चेकअप करवा के, अगर वो सजेस्ट करते हैं तभी जाना चाहिए.
आई थिंक वंडरफुली एक्सप्लेन हमको मेडिसिन के साथ साथ बहुत अच्छी अच्छी आई थिंक द रेसिपीज ऑल्सो दैट यू सजेस्टेड, और जो जितने काढ़ा और वो सब भी आपने बताया है, बहुत इजीली हम घर पे बना सकते हैं, बिकॉज ये एक बिजनेस हो गया है, हम लोग को मार्केट में वो रेडीमेड कुछ लोग लाके बना रहे हैं, उससे अच्छा तो आप वो ये जो है घर में आप एक प्रैक्टिस बना दो, उसका मिक्सर बना के रख दो, एंड यू कैन हैव इट इन द डे एंड नाइट. सो इवन दो कोरोना है या नहीं है, आई थिंक ये एनीवेज बेनिफिशियल है, ये आपको कुछ नुकसान तो नहीं देने वाला, बिकॉज ये तो घर की चीजें है, बहुत नेचुरल चीजें है. आई थिंक इट इज गोइंग टू इफेक्ट यू इन अ बेटर वे. डॉक्टर, हाउ कैन वी कनेक्ट विद आयुष थ्रू यू?
With Ayush Ministry, you are asking?
Yeah, मतलब how can we be, because Sonal is asking us this question and she wants to know कि हम किस तरह से आपके साथ connect हो सकते हैं, so that we know everything better. Yes, she is an Ayurvedic doctor, so.
Yes, I am an Ayurvedic doctor. I have written my website in this, and Purva, you can type my number here.
If you, आपका नंबर मैं यहाँ पे कर लूँ, मोबाइल नंबर, I'll share her contact details.
Yes, and I am so sharing my number. If someone wants to consult me, then you can.
Because she also has her private clinic in Delhi, right? She also has.
And then you can contact me, and you can take an appointment from me. I do online consultation for foreign patients.
For some fantastic.
Yes, from US patients also, and there are many. International platforms on which I am giving talks. So if anyone is interested in this type of health talks, you can contact me for this also. Okay. You want to connect with Ayush. Sonal, you please talk with me. Okay.
Yeah, you can connect with Dr. Reena. And
I have shared my number. I will talk to you.
I will do. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Thank you.
And the medicines, doctor, if it is an international, because we have a lot of ladies from UK and all around the globe. So when you give a advisory online, so how do we get the medicines? Do you have contacts for that as well?
Yes. I can tell this.
For the medicines thing to be taken. Okay.
Yes.
Fantastic, doctor. So ladies, thank you so much. It was such a enlightening and wonderful session. I think Dr. Reena has given us many ways by which we can be healthy and prevent COVID-19. And this is also a very enlightening session over towards ki kis tarah se hum apni lifestyle ko bhi better bana sakte hai, even though corona hai ya nahi hai, everybody has to be really very strong. And Ayurveda has a fantastic contribution in all the medical emergency that we face. Agar pehle se humne isko precautionary follow kiya, to I think we don't have to be, you know, bimari ka koi shikar. So thank you so much, Dr. Reena. It was wonderful talking to you. And please follow her. I have shared her number. I have shared her link as well. So you can watch and go and watch the video for yourself. And yes, you can contact her through WhatsApp and also call her. She is available. And she's a fantastic human being as well. A very nice volunteer. And so thank you so much, everyone. Good evening to UK, good night in India, and see you all again with the next session from IIW. Thank you so Thank much. You. Good night.
Good night. Thank you.
Thank you.
Goodbye, everyone. Don't forget to tune in at Inspiring Indian Women for the talk by Darshini Joshi with some powerful women. So we have an ongoing session every day, UK time 6 or India time 2, according to the guest speaker. So do join the Inspiring Indian Women Facebook group as well as the page. We look forward to empowering and supporting each other to rise higher and stronger together. Thank you, everybody. Goodbye. Thank you, Purva Joshi, for a wonderful Thanks. Show. And Dr. Yes. Reena Arora, hope to see you more on Inspiring Indian Women.
Thank you.
Goodbye, everyone.
Bye. Bye.